According to members of parliament, the Education Committee's report that was released late last year is not fair since the survey was done around schools in Kampala. David Kabanda, the Kasambia County Member of Parliament, who represented the Speaker of Parliament as chief guest, noted that schools are extorting money from parents, yet the education system is supposed to be managed by the government.
Parliament by the vice chairperson of that committee, Honorable Kasper Tabigawa. The committee had visited different schools and the committee made some recommendations because most of these schools were extorting money from parents. This is an education system which is supposed to be managed by the government of Uganda, not by the schools themselves.
He has asked government to fully take over the education system to curb extortion in the education sector, especially in private schools. The legislator has further attributed the poor performance in government-aided schools to lack of supervision by leaders.
Sell education. Like, you're not supposed to sell healthcare services. We encourage our parents to stay calm as government, as parliament, as we handle this matter. Our government leaders, including the RDC, as members of parliament, we are the ones who pay these people. But how come they provide poor quality, yet they get, I will not say enough money, but compared to the private teachers, there is a much bigger. This comes back to us as leaders to carry out supervision and sensitization to make sure that our students, our pupils are given enough services.
Josephat Tumwesije, the Bugangaizi South Member of Parliament in Kakumiro District, highlighted the challenges faced by the education sector.
We want to appreciate that there's nothing that is in the full supply all the time. All the time there should be some, there would be always a shortage of something. So even in schools you have a shortage of teachers. But again, I want to talk passionately to the teachers that even when we are a few in school, we can still work together to handle the situation. I'm calling upon government to increase on the wage bill. Like in Kakumiro District, we still have a shortfall of about more than 200 teachers. We are still lacking.
The National Resistance Movement NRM Party spokesperson Rogers Mulindwa commended the NRM government for supporting the education sector by constructing seed schools, introducing UPE and USE programs, as well as universities.
Government has given priority to so many things but education inclusive. That's why we have UPE, the Universal Primary Education, Universal Secondary Education, and we have built universities, public universities, all government universities in almost every sub-region of this country.
Thanksgiving ceremony for the Bugangaizi South Member of Parliament, Josephat Tumwesije, was held at Maranatha SDA Church in Igayaza Town Council. Kakumiro District was attended by over 30 members of parliament, local leaders, religious leaders, among others. Report compiled by Godfrey Muhumuza for the news.